Hello students, today we will learn the second illustration, illustration number 2 for computing the aggregate turnover. See the question, I'll read out the question. Vivek Private Limited is having its manufacturing units at Mangalore and Chennai. It also has service unit at Mysore. From the following information, calculate aggregate turnover of Vivek Private Limited for the year 2020-21, make it 2021, for the year 2020-21. First one, sold goods from Mangalore unit to dealer at Delhi rupees 25 lakh. Sold goods from Mangalore unit to dealer at Mysore for rupees 5 lakh. Supplied goods from Chennai unit to UK for rupees 20 lakh. Rendered service from Mysore unit to a person located in Hubli rupees 1 lakh. Mangalore unit supplies non-taxable goods to Mr. Narayan at Bangalore for rupees 2,50,000. Supplied goods from Mangalore unit to SEZ located in Delhi for rupees 5 lakh. Total IGST, CGST and SGST paid by Vivek Private Limited for the year rupees 3 lakh. Supplied goods which are exempt from tax from Chennai unit to a dealer at Dharwad for rupees 20,000. So this question is asked for the year 2018 year question paper. With this information, we have to calculate the aggregate turnover. Now see the question here. Vivek Private Limited is having manufacturing unit at Mangalore and Chennai, and also has service unit at Mysore. So in three places they have the branches. So we'll see the supplies and we'll find out the aggregate turnover. So first one is sold goods from Mangalore unit to a dealer at Delhi. So it is a supply. So we have to add to the aggregate turnover. Sold goods from Mangalore unit to a dealer at Mysore rupees 5 lakh. So this also from Mangalore unit to Mysore is a supply. Dealer at Mysore. So it's a supply we have to include. Next, third one, supplied goods from Chennai unit, from Chennai branch to UK is nothing but export. So this one also we have to add. Rendered services from Mysore unit to a person located at Hubli. So Mysore unit to Hubli we have to add. It is a supply. Rendered service or supplied goods also we have to take. Then Mangalore unit supplies non-taxable goods to Mr. Narayan at Bangalore. So non-taxable goods also we have to include for the aggregate turnover. So it is from the Mangalore unit to Bangalore. So 2,50,000 we have to add. Supplied goods from Mangalore unit to SEZ located at Delhi. So Mangalore unit to SEZ we have to add to the aggregate turnover rupees 5 lakh. Total IGST, CGST and SGST paid by Vivek Private Limited for the year rupees 3 lakh. So this we should not include. So this is nothing but it's a tax paid. So we have to include only sales, not a tax here. So tax, so this tax has been excluded. Tax we should not include, only supplies or sale transfers we have to include, not a taxes. Then GST we should not include. Supply goods which are exempt from tax from Chennai unit to a dealer at Dharwad. So supplied goods which are exempt from tax is a supply we have to include for the aggregate turnover. Even it is exempt from goods which are exempt also we have to include for aggregate turnover. So solution is we have to write the heading computation of aggregate turnover. So all the items we have to take except IGST, CGST and SGST. So excluding this 3 lakh we have to include all the supplies. So the total answer you will get 58,70,000. So should write the note that IGST, CGST, SGST paid shall not be considered while calculating the aggregate turnover, as it is not provided in the definition of aggregate turnover. So write the note also. You can write note here or you can write directly here IGST, SGST, CGST paid, not a supply. You can write in the amount column not a supply or a nil, or else you can write even note also. Anyone you can write. Next, see the illustration number 3. See the question, illustration number 3. Roshni Private Limited is having its manufacturing units at Mandya and service unit at Mysore. From the following information, calculate the aggregate turnover of Roshni Private Limited for the year 2020-21. For the year 2020-21. First adjustment, supplied goods to Belgaum for rupees 28 lakh, export supply to Hong Kong for rupees 23 lakh, which includes non-taxable service of rupees 3 lakh. Supplied goods to her job worker Arun at Udupi for further processing rupees 10 lakh. Purchased goods from NGO at Delhi for rupees 30 lakh. Job worker supplied all the goods to a dealer at UK for rupees 12 lakh. A manufacturer in Kolkata received services from Mysore unit for rupees 5 lakh. Office of the central government at Karwar received a service from Mysore unit for rupees 10 lakh. A dealer from Srinagar received goods from Mandya unit, which are nil rate of GST for rupees 5 lakh. Total IGST, CGST and SGST paid by Roshni Private Limited for the year rupees 3 lakh. Zero rated supply made from Mandya branch rupees 10 lakh. So with this information, we have to calculate the aggregate turnover. Now see the question. Roshni Private Limited, he is having its manufacturing unit at Mandya and service unit at Mysore. So they have branches, manufacturing unit at Mandya and service unit in Mysore. So two branches they have. From the following information, calculate the aggregate turnover of Roshni Private Limited for the year 2020-21. So see here, first one, supplied goods to Belgaum for rupees 28 lakh. So supplied goods to a Belgaum. So Roshni Private Limited has supplied goods to a Belgaum, means it is nothing but sale. 28 lakh is included for aggregate turnover. Next, export supply to Hong Kong. So export supply also we have to include. Export to Hong Kong, 23 lakh we have to add to the aggregate turnover. So in this 23 lakh, which includes non-taxable services of 3 lakh. So in the 23 lakh, export is 20 lakh and 3 lakh is a non-taxable service. So the total 23 lakh we have to include for aggregate turnover, because even the non-taxable services also a part of aggregate turnover. So the entire amount we have to include. So we should not add 23 lakh plus 3. It is already included. 3 lakh is which includes, means it is already included. So 23 lakh directly we have to take. Next, supplied goods to her job worker Arun at Udupi for further processing. So this is not a supply here. This is not a supply or a sale. Supplied goods to her job worker. So this Roshni Private Limited has supplied goods to her job worker Arun at Udupi for further processing. So she has supplied goods to job worker for completing that goods to a final product, means for further processing of that goods. It is not a sale. It is supplied to a job worker for completing the work. So this 10 lakh we should not include for aggregate turnover. So goods supplied to job worker for further processing or for completing the work is not a part of supply. So it is not a supply. So in the amount column we have to write the same, and again in the amount column we have to write it is not a supply, or else we can write a note also. Next, purchased goods from NGO. So purchases or inward supply we should not take for the aggregate turnover. This also we should not take. So purchased goods from NGO not included, we have to take not included. This one is not a supply. This is not included. If you are confusing, write nil for all or not included for all. Purchased goods from NGO. Purchases we should not underline the word purchases. So purchases we should not include for aggregate turnover. So it is inward supply. It is not a supply what is told in the meaning of aggregate turnover. Next, job workers supplied all the goods to a dealer at UK for rupees 13 lakh. So job worker, after finishing the work, supplied all the goods to a dealer in UK, means it is a export. Here it is sold to a dealer, means it is not a return to the owner. So it is directly sold from job worker place. After finishing the work, this job worker supplied all the goods to a dealer, means it is a sale. So UK place is UK, so it is a export to UK. 12 lakh we have to take. Next, a manufacturer in Kolkata received service from Mysore unit for rupees 5 lakh. So here see carefully, manufacturer in Kolkata received services from Mysore unit. So this received means here it is not a purchases. So See here, manufactured in Kolkata, received service from Mysore unit. So it is received service from Mysore unit means Mysore unit has rendered service to a manufacturer in Kolkata. So this is indirectly given. Mysore unit has rendered services to a manufacturer in Kolkata. So manufacturer in Kolkata received that service. So it is included for aggregate turnover. So if received means it is not a purchases, it is a rendering of services we have to include for turnover, aggregate turnover. This 5 lakh we have to add. Next, Office of Central Government at Karwa received services from Mysore unit for rupees 10 lakh. This is also same case. Here, the Mysore unit has provided or rendered services to a Office of Central Government Karwa. So, that's why they have received services from Mysore unit. So this 10 lakh we have to include because Mysore unit rendered services. It is not a purchases or received services by a Mysore unit. It is a Mysore unit rendered service to a central government. So this one we have to include for a aggregate turnover. Next, a dealer from Srinagar received goods from a Mandya unit. So dealer from Srinagar received goods from Mandya unit which are nil rate of GST for rupees 5 lakh. So here, a dealer from Srinagar received goods from Mandya unit. It means that Mandya unit supplied goods to a Srinagar, dealer in Srinagar. So this is we have to add to the aggregate turnover. Even if it is nil rate of GST also, we have to add for the aggregate turnover. Next, to total IGST, CGST, SGST paid by Roshni Private Limited, 3 lakh we should not include. So for this we have to write not a supply. Then zero rate supply made from Mandya branch. Made from Mandya branch means Mandya branch applied the zero rated supply, that is 10 lakh we have to include for the aggregate turnover. So all the items we have to include. We have to exclude one is IGST, CGST paid, and here we have to exclude one is job worker after further processing, then purchased goods. So 3 points we have to exclude, remaining all we have to include. So for this 3 points in the solution also we can write this is not a supply. Purchase from goods from NGO is an inward supply not taken for aggregate turnover. Then this is also not supply. If you want you can write note the same here. Goods supplied to job worker is not a part of turnover. Then goods purchased, that is inward supply. Then SGST, CGST, IGST has to be excluded while calculating aggregate turnover as it is not provided in the definition of aggregate turnover. Then supply of goods directly by a job worker to a buyer, to a dealer is included in the aggregate turnover. So that is nothing but this one. So try to work out this illustration.